I remember one man got up and he says, I'm the Mahdi. You know, sometimes when people suffer psychologically, they begin to believe that they are somehow, you know, superhuman beings, and they start thinking they are the Mahdi, and they announce it that I'm a Mahdi, you know. And what happened is, one of the imams of the haram says, okay, so do you speak Arabic? He says, no. He says, Mahdi, don't speak Arabic. Mahdi, do you read Quran? He says, no, I don't. I can't read the Arabic. He says, Mahdi, and you don't read the Quran? Go and learn. Maybe you can try later to fool the people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. That's a sign of the hour. It's a sign of the hour. Ignorance. Ignorance is indeed one of the prophecies. It is very evil, because you will not know how to protect yourself from evil if you don't have knowledge. عَرَفْتُ الشَّرَّ لِأُوَقِّيهِ وَمَنْ لَمْ يَعْرِفِ الشَّرَّ يَقَعْ فِيهِ. I learnt about evil in order to protect myself from it. Whoever doesn't know what evil is will fall straight into it. If I don't know what is halal and haram, what will happen? I'll be eating things, I'll be consuming things, I'll be earning in a haram way without even knowing. How did I save myself? That brings me to another sign of the hour. The Prophet ﷺ says, a time will come, لا يبالي المرء أمن الحلال أكل أم من الحرام. A person will not be bothered whether he is eating from halal or from haram. They won't be bothered at all. I'm not worried. Don't we see that today? Halal and haram is not only about food, but yes, a large chunk of it has to do with food. Today we will go anywhere, we fly anywhere to any country, and all we are interested in is makan, 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 that's it, makan, makan, you know. One Malaysian actually thought that Makkah was makan. Allahu Akbar. I had to say, this is not makan, this is Makkah. It's not an N at the end, it's an H, you know. Someone must have put that little... you know, the H with a slightly shorter hand there, and they thought it's Makkah. Oh, there must be a lot of food. I've heard there's KFC there, McDonald's there, everything else. A'udhu billah, astaghfirullah. That's not how it is. My brothers and sisters, it's not all about food. It's got to do with what is halal, what is permissible. You will not die if you don't eat beef. You will not die if you don't eat chicken. You will not die if you don't eat that which perhaps is questionable. There are other things that no one will question. Yes, when something is halal, don't label it haram. Remember that. Because the Quran speaks about it.
وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَا تَصِفُ أَلْسِنَتُكُمُ الْكَذِبَ هَذَا حَلَالٌ وَهَذَا حَرَامٌ لِتَفْتَرُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ الْكَذِبِ.
Don't utter with your tongues the falsehood that this is halal, this is haram, in order to fabricate lies against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from yourselves. Halal and haram is determined by Allah. And Allah says,
وَمَا لَكُمْ أَلَّا تَأْكُلُوا مِمَّا ذُكِرَ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَقَدْ فَصَّلَ لَكُمْ مَا حَرَّمَ عَلَيْكُمْ.
What is wrong with you that you do not want to consume that which is halal, that which the name of Allah has been called upon its slaughter, and so on? What is wrong with you? You don't consume that. What does this mean? This means you cannot say something that is halal is haram. The same applies. You cannot say something that is haram is halal. Now there is a gray area in between. There will be something, some people are arguing. Is it halal? Some say it is. Haram? Some say it is. What do you do? You're in the middle. You either have knowledge. If you have knowledge, one of the two directions, you follow that knowledge. These people are saying it's haram, but I know that it's permissible. It's halal. Or these people are saying this is halal, but I have more knowledge than them in this particular regard, and I'm telling you that it is actually haram. If you have that knowledge, you don't have any doubts. Follow the knowledge. But the question is, when you are doubting, what do you do? Well, the sunnah is complete. The Prophet ﷺ has spoken about it in hadith of Nu'man ibn Bashir radiallahu anhu. I'm sure we've heard it so many times if you've been following Islamic talks closely or Islamic guidance. إِنَّ الْحَلَالَ بَيِّنْ وَإِنَّ الْحَرَامَ بَيِّنْ وَبَيْنَهُمَا أُمُورٌ مُشْتَبِهَاتٌ لَا يَعْلَمُهُنَّ كَثِيرٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ. Hadith, long hadith in Sahih Muslim. The Prophet ﷺ says, the halal is clear, the haram is clear. In the middle, there are certain things that are not so clear, doubtful things that many people don't know. The benefit of the statement, many people don't know, it actually means some people know. Those people who know, we spoke about them a few seconds ago. You follow what you know. Those who don't know, the hadith says, فَمَنِ اتَّقَ الشُّبُهَاتِ فَقَدْ اسْتَبْرَأَ لِدِينِهِ وَعِرْضِهِ Whoever has stayed away from that which they don't know about, they have protected themselves because they haven't even gone into the probability of having consumed that which was not permissible. Meat in front of me. Someone says halal, someone says haram. I am confused. If I eat it, I got into the chance of having eaten haram. But the hadith says, if you did not eat it, nobody can say you were wrong. I didn't eat it. What did you have? I had vegetables. Make sure they were not cooked with wines. Allahu Akbar. You know, today that can happen. They say vegan, vegetarian. Not necessarily. There could be wine in there. You know, it's part and parcel of that. So be careful. But going back to the point, the hadith says, فَمَنْ وَقَعَ فِي الشُّبُهَاتِ وَقَعَ فِي الْحَرَامِ Whoever falls into that which is doubtful in the middle, that which they don't know about, they have fallen into haram because they were ready to take a risk regarding an item just for a burger. Come on, a burger. You could have done without it. I know there was tomato sauce, ketchup. I know there was beautiful mayonnaise, you know, dripping out of there. I know there were beautiful tomatoes and beautiful, and in some languages, in some accents, they say tomatoes. And I know that there was lettuce, and I know there was everything in there, and I know it looked so nice, and I know you were hungry. But if you feared Allah, you would say, I opt for a vegetarian meal. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. And here we're talking about when you're in doubt. You know, Malaysia, you are so lucky. You have a system that governs all of this from the top to make sure that nothing is going wrong. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them all goodness, whoever is sacrificing to make sure that that system works correctly. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all. Wallahi, you only appreciate a system when it's no longer there, in most cases. So at least appreciate this one while it's there. And believe me that when it's not there, then you start saying, hey, I wish we had a system like this and like that, without realizing. So this is halal and haram. A sign of the hour is people won't be bothered. They will be, evil will spread to the degree that people will consume anything and everything. They wouldn't be worried. Riba. Riba is interest and usury. People will call it a different name. The hadith says there will come a time when they'll consider it permissible. Call it another name. They call it bakhshish in some places. That means a gift. You know, when I first heard the word bakhshish, when I was very young, not too long after that, I heard the word hashish, and I thought they were relatives. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. They both had the shishas in it. And a little bit later, the shisha itself came out. Imagine. And the Muslims were found with all of those. And they're still calling themselves Muslimin. It's a sign of the hour. Life is not all about sitting in a shisha lounge and puffing away and thinking that you're going to heaven. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us a little bit more serious about our lives and even more serious about our death. You need to prepare for the akhirah. I'm not saying don't enjoy yourselves. Make sure it's clean fun. It doesn't have to be dirty. It doesn't have to be something, you know, people like to puff. You put in a cigarette in your mouth, you pull it in. I know one uncle used to make rings. You know, you have onion rings. He makes smoke rings. And the ring comes out. He says, oh, look at that. Look at that. And another ring comes out. Look at that. Allahu Akbar. That doesn't make it halal. As interesting as it is, it's still bad for your health. It's evil. My brothers and sisters, quit the bad habits and you will, inshallah, be contributing not only towards your own benefit, but society and community at large, the ummah at large. Remember this, Qiyamah will not take place until Allah's anger is so much that there won't even be a single person on earth saying Allah, Allah. This means one of the signs of the hour, no one's going to read salah. So when you are now lazy, you don't want to pray, you sit back, you relax, it's okay, you know, I heard this morning Allah is Ghafoorul Rahim, Allah is forgiving. I'm sure He knows that I need to sleep because I need to go to work. Whoa! You don't know today, before you go to work, Allah is going to take you away, back. This was your last chance to read your salah and you didn't. This is why there will come a time when people won't even read salah. They won't even say Allah's name. They will be ashamed. They won't say Allah. So you won't hear anyone remembering Allah, talking about Allah. No salah, no zakah, no hajj, no nothing. Because there won't be anyone saying Allah, Allah, according to the hadith. The anger of Allah will take over to the degree that He will declare that the trumpet be blown and the world will come to an end. Everything will be destroyed completely to smithereens. Allah will not destroy anything unless it deserves to be destroyed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not cause the world to end if there is even a single person who's worshipping Him. So you and I do not want to become statistics. Remember that. We don't want to be moving signs of Qiyamah. Every time you are lazy with your salah, you are a person. Remember, the next generation will be even more lazier than you. Even more lazy than you. Remember this. So fulfill it. Get up for the sake of Allah. How long does it take? It doesn't take too long. There will be people who will abandon reading the Quran. They will abandon it.